it feels great to be standing here in front of so many future leaders. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to the fourth edition of GIC MUN. Today, we give you one of the most pressing problems throughout the world, and we ask you to be change makers and give justice to the thousands of people waiting. This year, we try to accommodate all possible global issues that have either been caused by historic councils or are being faced by a present population due to our lack of awareness. Today, you have the power to simulate those fundamentals which failed and led to war, poverty, injustice, and environmental degradation. Many of you have been asked to represent national agendas or stands that you may personally disagree with. This open-mindedness is the essence of successful diplomacy. The ability to understand and analyze all positions, including those that you oppose. Your acceptance of differing viewpoints distinguishes our conference, and I believe it will prove crucial as you assume leadership roles in the 21st century. As famously said by our Honorable Prime Minister, in the year 1997, birds used to tweet. Now human beings are tweeting. There was a time when images of rivers and forests would pop up when one searched Amazon on the internet. We're all connected now. We live in a world where zeros and ones are just floating around. So what impacts one in one corner of the world will eventually impact us. Now what form this impact is going to be in is in our hands. The problems are everywhere, and as leaders of the future, we give you the power to come up with innovative approaches to help confront the challenges facing the global community. What we ask from you today is to stand up and help us make a better world. A world that is connected in all sorts. A world where every boy and girl live at par. A world where you and I have faith in our leaders. A world where you and I can stand up and work towards a better future. Our first committee is the Paris Peace Conference. Despite the Treaty of Versailles and other treaties from the Paris Peace Conference being drafted almost 100 years ago, our world today is still marked by the decision made during the summer of 1919. You will debate the fate of defeated Germany and how to solve the many territorial disputes caused by the Great War. The committee will be chaired by Koma Mikala and Vice Chair Nazi. I request you to stand. Our second committee is the Supreme Soviet of the Soviet Union. After overthrowing the centuries-old Romanov monarchy, Russia emerged from a civil war in 1921 as a newly formed Soviet Union. The world's first Marxist communist state would become one of the most biggest and most powerful nations in the world. Delegates will be seen discussing alternatives as compared to those which resulted in the dissolution of USSR. The committee will be chaired by Teshi Sharma and Vice Chair Diya Shah. The necessity of partition, borders and accession of princely states, special powers and privileges granted to accessing princely states. The committee will be chaired by Rana Barua and Vice Chair Manikar. Our fourth committee with one of the most disputed agendas is Lok Sabha. Delegates will be asked to solve the Ayodhya dispute, where they will be representing the two major parties involved. The committee will be chaired by Manan Chiroda and Vice Chair Sanjana. The Latin American Parliament will be seeing delegates discuss the ongoing issue of Venezuela. Venezuela is facing an unprecedented economic and political crisis. Delegates will be asked to solve this, representing different nations. The committee will be chaired by me, Teshi Sharma, and Vice Chair Rajesh Gupta. For this conference, Islamophobia existed in premise before the terrorist attacks of September 11, 2001. And it increased in frequency and notoriety during the past decade. The committee will be chaired by Khushi Aslam and Vice Chair Diya Mansurkar. The United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. We're all aware of the real-time effects of global warming, and it is high time that we take action. The committee is expected to come up with an action plan making policies that help in control and reduction of global warming. The committee will be chaired by Gaurav Irnani and Vice Chair Soham Agarwal. Delegates, let me commend you on the most rapid ascent possible in the diplomatic services. You enter this hall as junior delegates and you will leave as ambassadors. Dear future leaders, I thank you all for your commitment and wish you all a most stimulating conference.
With the power vested in me, bestowed upon me as Secretary General, I declare this conference open.